Hey everyone. The title of this session is "It's the best way to deploy open application on OpenStack." Time has come, so let's get started. First of all, let us introduce ourselves. I'm Hidekazu Nakamura. I have experience with creating web application for 7 years. From SX, started to work with OpenStack as operator, committed some patches to docs. I'm contributing to Murano project from Mitaka Saiko as a developer. He is Shu Muto.
Hi, I'm Shu Muto, a web developer. I had customized SX and for some Horizon with our customer. Started to contribute to Horizon and dashboard plugins since last September. And now I'm Magnum UI core reviewer and internationalization liaison for Magnum UI.
This is the outline of this session. At first, we explain purpose of this session, and we define actors for deploying application. After that, we explain each project which may be used to deploy application on OpenStack, cloud-init, heat, Murano, community app catalog. For each project, we explain project outline, pros and cons for deploying application, show suitable applications. Finally, we summarize this session. While we are here, I happened to attend Community App Catalog session at Tokyo Summit and had some questions. Why Community App Catalog 3.3 packaging? Murano packages, heat templates, glance images. Murano itself is an application catalog service. Community means what? Third, there are other projects which deploy applications such as Solum. What's the difference? So, we are going to talk about which application is suitable for these services. We support these four actors need to deploy applications. First, application developer. They develop applications. Second, application distributor. They package and distribute applications that are developed by developers. Third, application operator. They get applications from distributor and deploy them. Fourth, application user. They use applications become available by operators. So, first we explain glance. Glance is image service for managing virtual machine images and its metadata. User create virtual machine images and upload them. Community provides a guide how to obtain, create, and modify virtual machine images. Virtual machine image can be shared between projects. Virtual machine image is usually categorized by OS first. But application's point of view, application can be included in the image. So what is grounds for the actors? What the actors should do? Application distributor creates an image that includes applications. Application operator register the image and launch an instance from the image. Application user needs the application installed in the instance. The pros and cons are derived from the fact that the image includes the application beforehand. The advantages of using GRANs are, first, deploy speed. Application user can use the application in a very short time. Second, deploy reliability. Application is installed in the image, so application is certainly installed. On the other hand, the disadvantage is configure application is not possible in advance. For example, you cannot configure username or password before boot. This can be a security risk. As a result, application which has no need to configure for starting use is suitable for GRANs. For example, desktop applications such as deployment environment, editor, calculator, clock, auto viewer are suitable for GRANs. So next is cloud-init. So what is cloud-init? Cloud-init is Python scripts which handles early initialization of a cloud instance. For example, setlocale sethostname, copy SSH public key, install and update packages, use puppet shift server. Cloud-init is not OpenStack project, but open source project. And cloud-init is pre-installed in most cloud image. Cloud-init can execute files which is sent from outside when booting. So what is cloud-init for the actors? And what the actors should do? Application distributor creates an image that includes cloud-init and configure it. Actually, most cloud-init includes it and configure useful feature. Application operator registers image and launch instance from the image. Application user uses application installed in the instance. So the advantages of using cloud-init is unique configuration for each instance. Cloud-init is installed in the image and can configure each instance according to each instance environment. On the other hand, disadvantages of using cloud-init are, first, only one instance configuration is possible. Second, configuration timing is limited. Cloud-init works only when booting. Third, depending on the environment, it may be difficult to confirm status or to analyze errors. Since you need to see the output of Nova console log or directory C file inside of the instance. As a result, application which is enough for one instance and need to configure is suitable for cloud-init. For example, agent for monitoring some resources in the instance. or client of client server type software, or small scale application for private use. Next is Heat. Heat is template-based orchestration service for primarily managing infrastructure by executing appropriate OpenStack API calls. Template allows creation of most OpenStack resource types. Template is text file which are readable and writable by humans and can be managed by version control tools. Heat is well integrated with software configuration management tools such as Puppet, Ansible, and Chef. Software deployment resource type applies software configuration to one instance. Software config store software configuration. Shell script, Puppet, Ansible, or Chef. Nova server resource type means virtual machine instance. Software deployment resource type associates a config resource with one instance. Software configuration can be written in the template directory or can include a file by getFile function. But it's not enough for some cases. I'm an Ansible fan, so I wanted to apply playbooks based on Ansible-based practices directory structure. Best practices create role group variable for each environment. I wanted to use that structure. Ansible playbook searches roles, group vars, host vars, etc. from the directory it exists. So I must copy the playbook directory to the directory includes automatically generated playbook. But since this example is for image created by disk image builder specifying Ubuntu OS, the placement of playbook may be different. Anyway, this is fairly tricky, I think. I hope smarter way. So what the heat for the actors, what the actors should do. Application distributor creates template files or creates software configuration files. Application operator gets the template files and run or gets the software configuration files, create template files, merge them and run. Edit the template and run, heat finds the difference and executes it. So that is the advantage of using heat is the following. Most OpenStack resources can be used. By using Solum-meta resource types, auto-scaling application can be achieved. Puppet, Ansible, and Chef are integrated. Application configuration without changing just resources. By writing your own resource plugins, you can use external services. On the other hand, the disadvantage of using Heat is varying. Application distributor or operator have to study how to write template files. But Heat template language is declarative and writing it fairly easy. application operator have to manage template files by their own tool. And as I said, using Ansible with rows, groupers needs to use Ansible with rows needs tricky way. As a result, application which need to use various OpenStack resources is suitable for Heat. OpenStack resource types are, for example, Neutron load balancer services, Serometer, Trove. Trove is database as a service, etc. Or large scale application, which is frequently needs to scale up or down your resources. For example, data analyzer or search engine, I think. Next project is Murano. Murano provides UI and API to easily compose, deploy, run applications, and manage their lifecycle, including instances. Even users unfamiliar with cloud environments choose from the available applications with an intuitive UI. At first glance, you cannot take your eyes off web UI, but Murano power is beyond UI. Murano application package structure is the following. Murano application package is archived as a zip file. Zip file includes a manifest file. Manifest file is an entry point for each Murano application and it's very similar to the manifest of a jar archive. Zip file includes a picture used in the catalog. UI directory contains YAML file, dynamically creates UI. Classes directory contains YAML files. Application class definition written in Murano programming language. This including spawning instance, creating security groups. Resource directory contains scripts directory. Scripts directory contains all script files required for an application deployment. And YAML file that describes the install process of an application on the virtual machine. Murano programming language class is a core of Murano application. So, Murano programming language is represented by YAML and YAKO. YAKO stands for Yet Another Query Language. Murano programming language is object-oriented language. Murano PL class is a YAML dictionary with predefined key names. Example is shown on the right side. Instance, network, and security group are defined as class. Hot template is dynamically created and executed for creating infrastructure. Murano is application first. Murano defines application class for reusing. This is WordPress example. WordPress class is defined on the left side. When deploying WordPress, instantiate Apache HTTP server class and call deploy method. So application deployment. Tenant manages applications in the environment. Once tenant deploys the environment, network subnet and router are created automatically. Network is customizable. So Murano use case, application distributor creates Murano application packages and upload them to Murano. Application operator selects the application from UI or CLI and deploy it. So pros and cons. The advantages of using Murano the following. First, Murano provides means of creating application catalog UI. Second, as I explained, application is defined as reusable component as class. Murano has plugin architecture, so by creating plugin, application can connect to external services. Glass image and heat hot template can be packaged. So you can manage glass image heat template as application. On the other hand, disadvantages of using Murano are, first, since there are few documents, study Murano is deep learning curve. And Murano programming language is actually programming language. Bugs are inevitable. So which application is suitable for Murano? Systems composed of various applications is suitable for Murano. Various applications are for example, web server, application server, memory cache, database, monitoring agent, identity provider, job management. Next is community app catalog. A community app catalog is community-driven application catalog, containing glance images, heat templates, and Murano application packages. Community App Catalog's website is appsopenstack.org. Horizon plugin is also available. So, use case, application distributor publishes glance images, heat templates, or Murano application packages to the public location. It's shown in the website and dashboard. Application operator browses and selects glance images, heat templates, or Murano application packages from public website. Copies the name or URL to your OpenStack environment and deploy it. User can directly deploy through dashboard. So pros and cons. Advantages of using Community App Catalog is unified catalog of applications across Glance, Heat, and Murano. Disadvantages are to publish applications, change source code of Community App Catalog. Community App Catalog is not for private applications, and Internet Connect is a must. So, which application is suitable for Community App Catalog? Basically, applications open to the public is suitable for community app catalog. For example, test image developer want to use. Second, sample application. Third, commercial software to be advertised. So, conclusion. We saw four projects, but there are missing features. Some features are accomplished by integrating with other projects or writing programs. First, unified application catalog for both public and private. Second, application management. Data protection, monitoring, alert, metering. SMUG project application data protection as a service is targeting data protection. Monitoring, alert, and metering may be achieved by Selometa or Monasca, depending on your requirement. Third is development support. Test, continuous integration, integration with developing tools such as Eclipse, integration with version control system. In terms of development support, Solum is targeting. From application characteristics, I summarize project selection process. If application needs only one instance and need no configuration, use grants. If need to configure, grants plus cloud-init. If application needs several instances, Heat or Murano. If application is fairly simple or uses various OpenStack projects, use Heat. If not, use Murano. If you want application to open to the public, use Community App Catalog. That's all. Thank you. Any questions or comment? Yes.
Yo, what does that mean? Hello. Several of your projects listed as a con study cost. Could you explain what that means?
Okay. Several pages. Study cost. Okay. This is a slide of Heat. Heat study cost.
Is it learning curve?
This about Heat. I see. We have to study mainly how to write template of heat template, hot template, or mainly hot template. Murano, about Murano, how to packaging D5 or writing Murano programming language. I think mainly Murano programming language.
Thank you.
Murano plugin language, there are few documents now. So they deep learning curve. Any other questions?
I have a question. The user init or the cloud init field, will that vary by implementation? What ID is going to be used to execute whatever is passed through cloud init?
Pardon?
The parameters.
What? Sorry?
That's okay. The parameters passed in cloud init. Are they executed as root, or are they executed as a user specified by the implementation?
The question was, when cloud init runs, are things executed as the user or as root? The answer is that cloud init runs as root. Because it's basically happens early enough in the bootstrap process before anything else exists.
You mean cloud init is executed by root or user? Which is?
What user will be used to execute commands you're passing or scripts you're passing in the field? He explained that.
Okay. Tato, thank you.